If, let's say, for example, if somebody stole, he doesn't go to Gehinnom. He has to come back in a Gilgul. He has to pay back whoever he stole the money from. So if he can't, if he comes back as a human being, that means he has to work for that person that he stole from. Or maybe he's going to come back as a horse. Like we have a story from the Baal Shem Tov. Baal Shem Tov knew, we had Ruach HaKodesh, knew that one of the horses of one of his Talmidim had a soul of his neighbor, of his friend, that owed him money. He had to come back as a horse and serve his neighbor until he died, just for owing him $500 or something like that. So he knew that this soul had to come back. He couldn't go to Gan Eden, couldn't go anywhere. Why? Because he stole money. When you owe money to people and you could pay back, you don't pay them back, it's considered stealing. So, and if you stole outright, you can't go to Gan Eden, even if you kept Shabbat and everything else. It's very, very important for people to know that with blood on your hands, meaning stolen money on your hands, you cannot enter Gan Eden, even if you kept the rest of the Torah. If you stole money from people, you have to return the money in order to go to Gan Eden. It's very, very important for you to return it. Now, what happens if the person that you stole it from doesn't exist anymore, you have no contact with them, or perhaps it's a company, a big company, where you know that if you go to this company and you will give them the money, maybe they'll arrest you. Or you have no way of returning the company money. Let's say it's a big company, and you can't go to the cashier and say, hey, listen, 20 years ago I stole, you know, $500 worth of Twix from you. Here's the money. You're going to give it to the cashier. Cashier puts it in the pocket. She's not giving it to Walgreens. So what do? That kind of money of either a person you cannot reach after you've tried, or an entity that could put you in danger, that money you have to donate it for something that's going to benefit the public, where in the name of those people, so in the name of that organization or the person that you stole, and just in your mind you do. You don't have to write on a check, this is in the name of Walgreens, this is in the name of Steve. You don't have to do that. Just in your mind, I am, you know, donating this money to this public benefit to make up for the money that I stole 10 years ago, 5 years ago, 30 years ago. And that way you give it to the benefit of the public. Now what's benefits the public? It could be a homeless shelter, it could be KIRUV, it could be some park that benefits society, all types of things that benefit the public, and you do it that way. That way you clean yourself up. Now what if you don't have the money, meaning you stole 5,000 but really you only have 500? Well, start with 500 and then work yourself up and little by little give the rest of the money. You don't have to pay it all back in one shot if you don't have it. But if you have it, pay back as soon as possible because you don't know if you're going to survive. You don't know how long you're going to live. Don't make a payment plan where you don't need one. So for a sin like that, like stealing, a person can't go to Gan Eden and he can't go to Gehinnom either. He has to get an opportunity to recover it. Now, if a person is got enough chances to recover stolen money, and he didn't recover it, and Hashem says, no more gilgulim for this person, then the Reshit Chochmah says, there's a special malach, a few group of malachim that feed him sand in Gehinnom, in one of the sections. They feed him sand over there. You see in the shiur I did about Gehinnom, it talks about that. Not a fun thing, I promise you. It's not tasty. And it's not even soft sand either. No sauce, nothing. So, bottom line is, you stole something, return it. That's my suggestion.